Hi, glad to see you, at least in one direction. In fact, I would prefer to see you live. No, never mind. Let's go on. So we start a new course, which can be called Advanced Calculus. Let me first introduce myself, if you don't know me. My name is Alexander Schnirelmann. You can always reach me by email if you have questions or requests and so on. Request is alexander.schnirelmann@concordia.ca. Now, it is important to have feedback, so I propose Zoom office hours, so every week office hours, Zoom, say Thursday one PM to 3 PM. If you cannot attend or have some problem, just write me. We can find other possibilities. So one other thing. So I will post the lectures on video every week, so you have every week a week's portion of videos. Now, usually it will be about three videos lectures every week. It is very important that I also will give you weekly quizzes. What is quiz? I think you know it is a small problem, or maybe two or three problems, but really small and straightforward, just to control that you understand what happened during this week. The quizzes will be given every Friday, and I will give you about say 2 days to complete them, and return me by email. So you have to write it, say, on paper, to make a picture. If you will scan it, it is even better, and send me by email to this address. All this information will be on the outline. So if you cannot read my handwriting, you will see it on the outline. So we have together about 12 quizzes. So it is important. No, first it is a considerable part of the final grade. And second, even more important, that it is a feedback for myself and for you, which is even more important. Because from my experience, sometimes it appears to be clear, but when you have to do something with your hands, it turns out that it's not so elementary. Please regard it as an important part of the of your work. I have to warn you that this course has a rather steep learning curve. So we start from today from elementary things which you almost certainly know, just to remind you, but then we will reach very non-elementary things very soon. So please try to keep up, so you should not be left behind, because it will be really hard to make it if you lose a couple of weeks. Then it will be hard, because the amount of material is very large. Okay, so it was, yes, and one other thing, that fortunately for this course I have a full set of lecture notes, so which correspond to what I am telling you. So lecture notes and references to the movies and all information will be posted on the Moodle. So you will have ample material for this course. And of course, if you have questions, please write me emails anytime. Okay, so now let me start our course really from the beginning. So today we start from vectors. It is the main, I would say, main person in all this play. So what is a vector? No, we can simply consider vector as a segment with arrow on one end. Arrow has no functional meaning. It is just to show what is the origin and where is the tip. So it is oriented segment, say AB. Yes. So vector has a length or has a length and has a direction. So we can approximately define a vector as an object having the length or magnitude and direction. Now if you have two vectors, AB and say vector CD. So vectors AB, I denote them this way, the two points and the arrow showing which point is the first, which is the last, equal CD if and only if the figure, this A, B, D, C is a parallelogram. No, this means that they have equal lengths and are parallel and have the same direction. In this case, I regard them as equivalent or equal, like this. if we have this configuration, so they have the equal length, are parallel but have opposite direction, then these vectors are called A, B, C, D. In this case, A, B, D, C is not a parallelogram, and we have that A, B, and C, D are antiparallel. Yes, in this case, they are not equal. So it is the first thing. Now, if the vector is two vectors are equal in this case, so we can shift it arbitrarily in the plane. So we can choose some origin, some point which we decided is an origin, and count all the vectors from this point. So we will fix one point, the end point of the vector, and count this vector from this point. So the vector is denoted by one letter. No, say letter is if vector OA is denoted by this bold A. Yes, so we have to somehow distinguish vectors and numbers or scalars. So we have to choose some notation. We can denote vector by, say, A, B, C, F, like this bold face. Or it can be, say, A bar, B bar without bold, C bar, F bar, we can write this, or A cap, B cap, and so on, F cap. So you can choose anything which distinguish vectors from scalars. I will use the bold face because it is habitual in between mathematicians. So mathematicians like this bold face. The obvious examples of vectors. Examples. First, position vector. So let's choose the origin O, and if you have a point A, then the vector connecting O and A with the tip at the point A is called position vector of point A. So we set some correspondence between vectors and points. Second, displacement vector. So if you have some figure or some object or even some point, and then we move it parallel, make a parallel shift in a new position, then this vector, say B, is a displacement vector showing how much and in which direction this object was shifted. Then it can be velocity vector. We have, say, a point moving along some curve, and every moment it has some velocity. V is velocity vector. It can be, say, force vector. So, we have, say, some body, and we have a force, which is applied to this body. No, for example, the gravity force. It is also example of an object which is described by a vector, because force has magnitude and it has direction. Now, we can add a numerable set of other objects which are described by vectors. Yes, now if you have a vector, as I said, it is described by its magnitude and its direction. So if you have a vector A, magnitude is denoted by this way. No, in mathematics it's called norm of A. Magnitude, no, depending on what is the nature of this vector, magnitude is measured in different units. For example, if it is just a geometrical vector, then it is length of this vector. The direction of this vector is described by this angle phi. Sometimes is it is denoted by argument of A. No, it is not universally accepted notation. So it is usually direction is described by angle between the positive direction of, say, x-axis and the vector. Now, for now, let us consider just geometrical vectors without further reservations. Consider what are the vector operations. No, first addition. Which we certainly know, but let me remind you. Suppose we have two vectors, and they both grow from the same point O. It is vector A, and this vector B. We have two vectors. How to define the sum? No, one, we have two rules. One rule is define it as a diagonal of parallelogram. So we complete this pair of vectors to the parallelogram and take the diagonal, which is denote C, and by definition C equals A plus B, by definition. Yes? It is one definition. Other definition is the following. We take vector A and then draw vector B, vector which is equal to vector B, starting at the tip of vector A. And take the third side of this triangle, going from starting point of A to the tip of vector B. And this is C. Now you can observe that this is just a half of this parallelogram. So these two definitions are equivalent. They give the same vector. But they are equivalent, but it does not mean that they have the same force, I would say. So let me take consider the first thing. What are the properties of this operation? Properties. First property is that for any two vectors A and B, A plus B equals B plus A. So the addition is commutative. Now how to prove it? It is obvious from this picture, because this construction does not take into account the order of the terms A and B. We simply draw A and B, construct this parallelogram, find diagonal, and that's all. So this is proved by from parallelogram rule. Yeah. No, it is not hard to see it also from this picture, but it is it becomes obvious if you consider parallelogram. Second. If you have three vectors A, B, C, then we can, what is the sum of three vectors? We know how to add together two vectors, but what about three vectors? So we can write the sum of three vectors A, B, C in the following form. A plus B, and then plus C. And we can write alternatively A plus B plus C. And it turns out that they are equal. So how to prove this? Let us draw vector A. And we use the triangle rule, the second. It is vector B. Now say this is vector C. So what is the first? A first A plus B and then plus C. So we find A plus B. This is say D. D equals A plus B. This is D, and then we add C to this D. Yes, let us call it E. E equals A plus B plus C on one hand. On the other hand, if you try to find in this order, first find B plus C and then add it to the A, what does it mean? We find, let me draw it in other color. We find B plus C, it is this vector, say F, yes, and then we add A plus F. A plus F is the same vector because we can formulate both ways to get both left and right hand side. Simply, we draw A, then we add here at the tip of A, we add B, and then we add C. Yes, without even showing where we put the brackets. And our sum is this vector, F. This second property, is proved using the triangle rule. Now, these two properties make it possible to define the sum of any number of vectors. We can write, say, A plus B plus and so on, plus U plus X, for example, if you wish, sum of any number of vectors. We can simply draw this chain of vectors, first A, then B, and if you change places of any two vectors in this chain, you will get, after all, the same result by the first rule. So this means that we can simply, if necessary, omit the omit all the brackets and add the vectors in arbitrary order. Now, what about subtraction of this vector of vectors? One moment. Let me take another pen. Subtraction. What is A minus B? Let's denote it by C. Is a vector such that B plus C equals A. Just like with numbers. So how to find this vector, vector C? So it is, this is vector, say, A. This is vector B. And vector C is such that B plus C is A. So this vector should go from the tip of B to the tip of A. This is vector C. Yeah? So this way we define the subtraction of vectors. Now, the next operation is the following. Vector can be multiplied by a number or by a scalar. So multiplication of vector by scalar. Suppose we have vector A. And we have a number k. K may be positive, negative, or zero. Then we define ka, first of all, is parallel to A. Yeah? Length of ka equals modulo k. K can be positive and negative, so I write modulo k. Times length of A. Yes? So A, KA has the same direction if K positive. KA has opposite direction. With respect to A, if K is negative. So, no, for example, if this is vector A, yeah, then this is vector 2A. Yes? This is vector, I'm sorry, this is vector 0, 5 times A. Yes, this is vector minus 3A. Yes, so vectors can be multiplied by a scalar. I did not say about the case when K equal 0. To this end, I have to define what is zero vector. It is a vector such that its endpoints coincide. So vector say AA from going from AA, A to A is a zero vector. So unlike other vectors, this vector has no definite direction. Yes, or it has no direction, or it has it is directed everywhere. Anyway, it is exception, and its length. Yes, so this vector is denoted by zero vector zero. So zero bold zero, and we can define that zero. Zero times A equal zero vector for any vector A. Now we are done with this. Now what are the properties? No, let me list them and they are easy to prove. Either you believe me or you try to prove it yourself. So, because if you start to prove obvious things, they become less obvious after that. So, properties. Of multiplication by scalar. First, we can multiply the vector, it is like with numbers B K1 plus K2 A equals K1 A plus K2 A. Here K1 times K2 A equals K1 times K2 A. No, or equals K2 K1 A. And D, 0 times A equals 0, vector 0. Which I have already said. So these are properties which you certainly can prove yourself. They look simple, but together with the previous properties, they are very powerful. Let me write still another property. A minus B equals A plus minus 1 times B. So we can write this as well, so which you certainly will also prove yourself. It is the general structure. In fact, to have some apparatus, so to make calculations, we have to introduce coordinate representation of vectors. So, vector in coordinates. So, consider first a plane with coordinate system. These are x and y axis. Consider a vector. Say A vector going from the origin to some point A. Point A has coordinates. This coordinate x, this coordinate y. Yes? And so we can write this vector A symbolically. It can be defined by coordinates of its type xy, and say that xy are components of vector A. Yes, why components, not coordinates? Coordinates belong to a point, to point A, to the tip. So and the x and y are coordinates of A, of the point A, and components of the vector OA. You will see in a few minutes how it works. It is quite easy, quite natural. So if you have coordinates, then you have two important vectors, basic vectors. I is the vector with components 1 and 0, and j is the vector of components 0 and 1. So in the coordinates it looks like this. This vector I, this is the vector j. Yeah, so we have two basic vectors. Now I should introduce the how look the vector operations if you use this coordinate representation. Again, what I say now is so simple to prove that I would not do it myself. You can do it yourself. So suppose we have two vectors, A with x1, y1. So we have one vector which components are x1, y1, and B has components x2, y2. Then A plus B has components x1 plus x2, y1 plus y2. It is 2. Now A minus B has components x1 minus x2, y1 minus y2. Ka equals kx1, ky1. No, correspondingly, kb is kx2, ky2. So this is how the vector operations look in coordinates. Now, in now, what is if you have the vector, no, any vector with components x, y, then we have this picture. This is x, this is y. The length of this vector or the magnitude is defined by the Pythagorean theorem. Square root of x square plus y square. So this is the length. Now we can similarly define the same word, literally the same, in our three-dimensional space. So the definition of geometric definition of vector operations, addition, multiplication, multiplication by number of zero vectors, remain the same. Simply we are not in the two-dimensional space, but in three-dimensional space. So in 3D space, D-dimensional space, we have a vector A equals, now let me use more consistent notation, A1, A2, A3. So A1, A2, A3 are coordinates of the tip of the vector A if its origin is at the origin. Yes? The magnitude of A by the three-dimensional Pythagorean theorem, you know this theorem that if you have the rectangular parallelepiped, then its main diagonal is defined by the Pythagorean theorem, which is square root of A1 square plus A2 square plus A3 square. Now we have here basic vectors. Here we have three vectors. I equals 1, 0, 0. J equals 0, 1, 0. And K, 0, 0, 1. Now, let me say a few words how to draw it in space. So in space we have three coordinate axes. So this axis, which is going from the plane of black whiteboard in our direction, is say x axis. The axis going horizontally is y axis, and the vertical is z axis. So we have to imagine that y and z are in the plane of the whiteboard, and the x axis is perpendicular. Yes, so here I is this vector, j is this vector, and k is this vertical vector. We see this beautiful picture. And now we can write, if you have a vector, say A equals A1, A2, A3, it is the same as vector A1 times I plus A2 times J plus A3 times K. Yeah, so we represent every vector in three space as the combination of the basic vector I, j, and k, as you can see here. And these numbers, we can say that these are, I would say, components of the vector. But we say about these coefficients that they are components. So vector is made of these three blocks, which are this each of them is a vector multiple of one of the basic vector or parallel to the vector. Now we can consider example. In three-dimensional space, say A is a vector 1, 2, 3. B is a vector 3, minus 1, 2. Then the same we can write A equals I plus 2, J plus 3k. B equals 3i minus j minus we can say plus plus minus 1 times j, but I abbreviate to minus plus 2k. And now if you want to find say a plus b, no, let us find, it is coefficient 1 plus 3, it is 4, 2 minus 1, 1, 5, yeah? It is correct. Now, what is 2a, for example, equals 2, 4, 6, now and so on. 3a minus 2b. So we have to take 3 times 1, 3 times 1, minus 2 times 3, 3 times 2, minus 2 times minus 1, and the third is 3 times 3, minus 2 times 2 equals 3 minus 6 minus 3. 6 plus 2, 8. 9 minus 4, it is 5. Yes, so this way we find this. Now magnitude. Length of A, it is square root, is 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square. It is 1 plus 4 plus 9, it is 14, equals square root of 14. Length of B equals square root 3 square plus minus 1 square plus 2 square, it is 9 plus 1 plus, 9 plus 1, it is 10, plus 4, again it is square root of 14. No, I did not devise it with this purpose, it's just coincidence. Very good. Very good. And now we have these operations, and now I would like to transfer to next one, to next operation, but maybe I will do it after a small break.